Alright, guys. I should have bought one of these a long, long time ago. And I finally have the exhaust donut removal plier. I was a little confused with it, except for one little part, which I'll show you on how it worked. The first thing I note, this is a giant tool. I was expecting it to maybe be tiny. Now it makes more sense how it works because you have so much leverage. But this is probably over a foot long. So that's the first thing that I didn't really realize. And let's go ahead and open it here. Let me get you a higher view. Breeze clamps make really good camera mounting surfaces. I did get this on Amazon, of course. A little bit price, well, I wouldn't say it's pricey. But for what we're used to in America, it's pricey. You know, everybody wants something free. This was like 20, 25 bucks, which is a lot for a tool. For me, you know, I can usually get a wrench for 5 or 6 bucks, you know, a socket I need. And then I thought about all the years and years of headaches I've had from these exhaust donuts. And one of the main reasons I want this is to avoid all that big bruising on my forearms, all these cuts that occur. This is all from trying to get, I think it's actually a whole bruise. It's all from trying to get those that hanger off the mid pipe the other day on the Forester. So first off, the construction is good. Solid rivets. I mean, people are saying they're better than bolts. Long as they don't break, and I mean, Lyle isn't no king of brand names or anything, but you know, I've heard of it. I've seen Lyle around for 20 years, probably in the 80s. I was still they had Lyle, so you know, it isn't Harbor Freight quality. It's higher quality than that, I'll tell you that. You could probably get this for Harbor Freight at 10 bucks, and it might only last a year or two. So Lyle is decent. So before I show you, most of you probably know this, I was kind of going, let me set you up with a down angle. I was going like, well, sure, you can put this on the rubber. Oh, you know what? Maybe I have one. So let's say you put it behind here and you do the pull and you just squeeze. Now, what I was confused about is, how are you going to get this little tip to balance on this little cone-shaped thing and not slip? And I found my answer, of course. Anybody that has one already knows. This has a cone shape inside it, so it seats that little nub so it can't slide out from side to side. Now, I can't wait to try this out in a few minutes and show you what we're doing here, show you what this is all about. It'll be the first time in my life I've used one of these pliers. I'm real excited because I'm still, as I said, all beat up from the last one. So I'm also going to be addressing some valence measurements and things that we talked about in the previous video. So we'll just see how tough a project this is. I'm not worried about cutting the car, by the way. This is another, it's the same as the WRX situation, really. We never really had a plan to end the lease. We can buy it out for probably more than it's for less than its value. We'll have a little equity in it after 3 years, even if we buy it out. That thing was is a few thousand less than the Subaru, and its value is also a couple thousand less, but it's all kind of equal, where it's going to be at least even, if not better, at time of buyout. So we're not losing anything by paying whatever the buyout cost is. And especially if she still likes it, and I mean, it's such a hassle buying a new car, then dealing with the paranoia of having a new car, stuff like that. So, you know, we're not worried. I'm not worried about cutting it a little bit. I'm gonna do as slight as possible, obviously. I'm not gonna trash it, but I am gonna try and be careful and just see how hard it can be. And I just know that it's going to completely transform the look That's why I'm just really, really motivated to do this, just for really looks alone. And I don't want to use a WRX midpipe, even if I had one, because everybody that does it with the WRX kit on there talks about the drone at 1500. If you have a CVT, you know that it stays at 1500 a lot of the time. That's like a constant drone forever. Who the hell wants that? So that's why the STI pipe was the right one. I didn't really plan it that way. I just got super lucky. I had the STI pipe hanging on my wall. I said, dude, why didn't I think about this forever? Put it to some use. I don't want it on my WRX. My WRX is the perfect sound. I don't want it quieter or I'd be bored. So perfect. All the stars aligned. Oh my God, it's hot out today, guys. It's colder in my garage than, and I step out here, it's hot. It's like 70, 75 out here. And we did, our landlady is talking to the owners about either trimming or cutting down the tree. So that should be good too. So let me get to work on that. All right, let's start by buzzing off the muffler. You should be wearing safety glasses, by the way. Super easy. But then again, if you do this 10 or 20 times with the gun, you are eventually going to wear these things out. Man, it's so much easier than 3 minutes a side by hand, like I used to do. This thing's so long, damn it. But I need that wobbly just for that other side over there. I wish this thing wasn't so heavy. I don't want to drop it on my pinky again. Oh, okay.
Mommy, how long are you going to stay up tomorrow?
At least a half hour.
No. Can I have breakfast on your side?
Yeah, you can have it. I don't remember where it is. It's somewhere upstairs, probably. All right. You saw that picture I got for you? All right. All right. Let's see here. So, let me spray these puppies off. And we'll just see. That's gonna go in my eye. Just to get them moist. It doesn't need to be that wet. Alright. Let's see, which one should I try? Let me try something like that. Where the hell is this tool? What the hell is this tool about? Oh man. See, that's not that good. This rod is too big for this, so already it isn't the best tool in the world. Ooh, does that have okay. That's hollow. I thought it was solid, but since it's hollow, it can grab in there. See that? Oh man, killer. Whoa. All right. Now I'm gonna do the hard ones off camera, but let me do another one here. Let's do this one here. Let's see. You can probably see that pretty good right there. I don't want the thing falling, right? Use my knee. Oh, yeah! Oh my God, that's awesome. It's gonna be cake. I can't wait to do exhaust jobs for the rest of my life now. Now this is interesting. Remember that front one is hollow. The rear one is not, so the tool doesn't work well on the rear, but see, all you need to really do is get off one of them and then it's always cake. So I wonder if that's probably intentional. I mean, every bolt in the car is done for some reason. Maybe they made that hollow so you can use a pliers, and the outside one, you just push it with your hand. It's super simple. Estimate so far, and I mean, you could shove it and have it look like crap. I'm gonna trim it. So in the back corners there, is where it just touches. And then I can do something with my template, kind of figure out, so I want it, oh, there's the wrong side. This is the good side. So I really want it wide enough, starting at the bottom, you know, not up here, because it'll get stuck underneath, right? You want your widest point at the bottom. So I just wanted to confirm that with one fitment so I can work on the other side and just get a eyeball. It's very slight, maybe a half inch on each side, nothing at the top at all. So that's why you're gonna not touch like the top open loop up there. You're only gonna touch the sides. I gotta be careful on this. So I'm just using some yellows, it's whatever most temporary I can do. And I'm gonna kinda cut like there. I need to make a better circle right there. And see, I can continue that line straight to the back and then cut it here and figure out what kind of side piece I'm gonna do later. So we're getting there. It's right about where I need it. When it's straight, of course it's hard, it's all bendy, so I'm trying to just keep it flat somewhere right there. It's close, and I can fine-tune it with the razor later. So there's some panda dude that's like the expert at this, and he talked about getting it hot first, but I do want to just try a few things, and I do have the heat gun if needed. So that's, it's hard because it moves, but this is a brand new razor. I can see how this will take a little while. I'm wondering if some snips for a rough cut and then a razor to just fine tune and shred it a little bit better might be a good idea. It would cut a lot better, but I'm not sure how clean a cut it would be. I know, I can do a test cut on a part that's coming off. That's what I'll do. Wow, that shears is actually really good. We got like these little mini bikes always coming around here. All these kids on their mini bikes. Okay. And, you know, I'll clean it, sand it, razor it a little cleaner later. Let's see. I'll come in. Let me get my straights. These are my righties. These are my straighties. Something hidden back here. Right about to where I'm gonna stop the massacre. Let's see, push this out. It's a good angle to get in there. It's tricky, huh? Let me cut out a triangle. More room to work. Okay. I do like that these shears do give pretty good control for straight cuts, etc. Thank you. And you could even put a rubber finish on here to make it look factory later, you know. See, I gotta make sure I get this cut. Get a nice turn on this cut. Yeah, I'm gonna finish it up with some finisher later for sure. Make it look better. It'll need some cleanup. Find something to put, basically a thin hose to go right over that. Okay, let me get my lefties. You know if it's right or left, because of whichever one is on top. This is a lefty. This is a righty. And this is a straighty. Alright, let me pause for a while. This will be too long a video. You can get a cleaner cut with the razor afterwards. Actually, maybe it's better for you to see it over here. When it's thin, it's much easier to cut than when you're dealing with a big thick PC. So I'm just cutting a hair off the entire cut to make it a lot cleaner for starters. And then I'll probably still use a finisher. That's too much blade right there. Lock that in. And you just really want as little as possible. Let's have some eagle eye. Except I'm in my own frickin' light and I can't see what I'm doing. Very slow, take your time. See, it just peels away, peeling away the carrot. And at least it'll look better than the chunkiness. And then you are gonna wanna do some finisher too. I bet you're all saying right now, what the hell is he doing, man? He's crazy. He's stupid. I hope you are. I hope you're getting entertained by this video. Because I am loving it. Oh, look at that. Really sweet, sweet cut. Sweet, sweet rock. That's from an old cult movie called Frankenhooker. You guys heard of that? I doubt it. It's probably a California thing. Frankenhooker. This guy, what does he do? He mugs, he kills prostitutes to make a Frankenstein, and then it's a Frankenstein hooker. And then he's always selling crack to people too to make them addicted. Frankenhooker, look it up. Be very careful. If you're holding a brand new sharp razor like I am, like a saw, oh, let me get you a good angle on that. Should be from this side, I guess, now, because I change sides. So how about you change sides? Actually, I'll give you a side view, really see what's going on here. Do you like all my cheap-ass shitty camera views? Saw. Oh yeah, it's much easier if you hold it back too, because it's not flopping, you know? And I'm gripping tight. I'm not gonna let that slip and slice my finger open. And you can just shave it almost. You get a better light right there. Just shaving. Just really to get a somewhat smoother finish than the shears got you. And sure, I mean, you could razor the whole thing, but I don't think the time spent will be worth it when you can just do this afterwards. Need to shave a little bit off the pump down here. Pretty good right there. I gotta do this touch-up work. Let me get off camera for that. Pretty close and pretty badass, let me add. This side's really good. It follows the curve. This side, I need to cut that top corner, which isn't following the curve right. That's pretty much as close as I'm gonna get. I wanna stop trimming now. pretty even all the way around. I've got it as straight as I can get it with the hangers. And I can clean, I'm gonna put little cleanups on the edges there eventually, just to make it look a little more tidy. And that pretty much should do it. Of course, anytime you're gonna be up from a different angle, all you're gonna see is sweet, sweet exhaust pretty much. This car isn't even jacked up, so all you'll see is that for most of the time, unless you're sitting there on your hands and knees inspecting it super close. It's a pretty sweet, sweet look. Sit tight, guys. I'm almost getting there. Just working on the last one here. Doing some touch-ups. Okay, I'm just gonna try a little trim. All I got is some silicone hose here. I'm basically gutting it right down the middle. Only one way through. What are you doing? Whoa. You want to watch me for a minute? Uh-huh. Your nose, are you getting better yet?
Uh-huh.
You are?
Uh-huh.
All right.
You know what Daddy was?
Huh?
He called.
This hose is probably a little small for this task. I don't know though. Just gonna sit there and pat my muffler. Alright. Do. Okay, this is just a sample to just give you an idea of what I'm looking for. I need to find some perfect, you know, molding for the edges. Preferably a little flatter and not round, you know, and bulgy. Like a molding edge trim, but the texture is kind of important. And if it's extra bendable, I can go all the way, I can go in a little bit further and it'll kind of hide under there sort of thing. Like bend this line, but it's kind of hard to get that line bent with the hose. But that's just one example of how you could finish it. I do want to finish it a little bit cleaner than that. So this is just phase one right now. I didn't finish this one yet. So that's pretty much it. If I stand up, I just forget. It looks, man, I don't even, I'll find a different finish for later. I don't even want those hoses there. They don't look good. Looks better without them. It's pretty good. Of course, I can fine tune it later if I find spots that just aren't quite, I mean, you don't want to keep going bigger and bigger, but I can kind of see if anything wants a slight trim. That's probably close enough because from far back and everything, you're not gonna be able to tell the difference. So that's about it. Thank you. surprised. I can tell a sweet difference in sound, guys. The Forester did not sound like that before. That's sporty. Now, worst case, if I happen to have that 1500 drone, I can put it all back and have bigger holes there. But everybody that had that did not have a resonator. I have a resonator. I think it's going to do the trick. Here it comes quiet. Very quiet. So just the cold start is a little bit loud. Man, that looks badass. Get you another light before I finish this damn video. This was a big pain in the ass, guys. You don't know how many hours I spent trimming this thing. I love it. I'd like to clean it up a little bit so you guys can give me some tips. I'm sure hundreds of people have used different trims before. Any trim that I can put along that edge, or maybe I should just leave it alone just like that, nice and bare. Trim might just, you know, clutter it up and look more dirty. So that's it, guys. STI mufflers, well, probably WRX mufflers. I can't remember to tell you the truth. WRX mufflers and STI midpipe on a 2015 Forester XT. Success. I'm gonna clean up tomorrow. I am just beat.